Hi guys, good morning all of you. Today we are going to look at the types of questions which you will have for the examination, even for gate examination. They will ask you construct LL1 parser or predictive parser given CFG, for the given CFG. For the given CFG, they will be asking you to construct. This is one type of question. This is type one. There would be another question. Verify whether the given CFG is LL of one or not. This would become another type of question. Type two. So it would be anything. How to decide whether the given CFG is LL1 or not is the point of discussion today. We all know that if we want to design LL1 parser, given the grammar, we need to verify free from ambiguous or ambiguity. That means the grammar should not have more than one leftmost tree or more than one rightmost tree. Either it should not have more than one leftmost tree, nor it should have. Either or, whatever. So it should not have more than one leftmost tree or more than one rightmost tree. That is for clear. Next, elimination of left factoring. Elimination of left recursion. These are all we need to ensure. That is a very first step. I can say it is pre-processing step. Once if we are done with these all three steps, next we need to move for first and follow computation. After first and follow computation, we need to design the table. The table is called non-recursive parser table, or we can name it as LL of one parsing table or predictive parsing table. Once the table is ready, we need to consider one sample input string by ourselves, or in the examination, the question will be given asking or stating that parse the given input string. In the earlier case, we started discussing ID plus ID star ID. That is what the input string we have considered. So along with the question itself, sometime you would be getting the input string, or we need to phrase, or we need to form the input string suitable to the grammar. You would have come across the question in your formal languages. What is the language generated by this grammar? Then you will be doing, no? You will be simulating. You will come to know what is the type of grammar. In that manner, you need to find out some valid input string. You need to parse. How you need to parse? You need to consider stack memory, and you need to consider input buffer. Stack memory and input buffer together you need to simulate. And looking into the table, that is called almost looking. You will be looking into the parse table. Always you will be forming the pair. The pair is going to become non-terminal and terminal. This is the combination. Understand. The earlier case we have seen, today also we are going to see. Don't worry of that. So what we will be doing, these are all the steps. Whatever the given problem, check free from ambiguity. It should be free from ambiguity. First step. Number one, free from left recursion. Whatever I said, I am recapping. Then free from left factoring. After this, all fourth step, you need to find out first computation. You need to do first computation. Next, you need to do follow computation. Next, you need to do parse table. That parse table is either LL1 or LL2. 1 minute. This is called as LL1 or predictive parser or non-recursive parser. These are all the possible things interchangeably called. Then you need to consider, or it will be given. Input string is given. You need to do the parsing action. This parsing action need to be done with stack memory and input buffer and action table. That action table always looking at the entry M of capital A comma A. This is the way to represent. This is called capital A comma A is termed as function. Always you will be looking at this A stands for top of the stack. What we did that small a stands for left most symbol in the input buffer. Input buffer. Leftmost symbol in the input buffer is termed as A. These are all the possible steps you need to consider for designing LL1 or LL2. Now, next question. This is for the first type of question. These are all the steps you need to do. What are you supposed to do for second type of question? This is type 1, this is type 2. When the question comes like this, what you're supposed to do is the point of discussion today. What you supposed to do for this, you need to do all the 7 steps. Surprisingly, you may feel surprised. Surprisingly, the same steps. What is the 8th step is, if the table has multiple entry for any of the action small capital A comma small a, then it is not LL1. This is the 8th step. Today we are moving towards this 8th step. That is the point of discussion today. Remaining all the 7 steps going to become same for the type 2 question. Verify whether the given CFG is, it is dangerous question. It may be LL1, may not be LL1. So when we will come to know during the step number 8, all the 7 steps we supposed to follow. At the time of step number 8, we will come to know whether the given grammar is LL1 or not LL1. This is what the type of discussion today we are going to do. Look at this carefully. Then if you have any question, you please ping me in this chat box, or you can unmute yourself and discuss with me. Then I'll proceed. The same procedure, 7 steps. Given the grammar, you need to do everything the same. Only 8th step, we are going to become look into different perspective today. That's all. Step number 8 only pending. Rest all we have done. Is it clear? All the 7 steps are clear. 7 steps, if you are clear, that is sufficient. Guys, come on. Respond me, any one of you. Don't be like this idle. Is it clear? Shall I proceed for the next problem? With that problem only, we are going to conclude. Yes. Thank you, Mom. Yes. Now, these are all the 7 steps. It's a kind of recap. Recap also I'm doing. In addition, there are 2 types of question will come. First type of question, nothing to worry. You will be doing these all steps. Second type of question, you need to think for the 8th step. That's it. Now let us consider. For this particular grammar, you need to come out with first and follow. Consider this is the production. For this production, what is the first? It has S symbol followed by small I, capital C, T, S, S dash, R, A. You need to tell me. First. First of S. Ultimately, I'm asking first of S. Yeah, excellent. I comma A. First of S. Look at S is the symbol you need to consider. Look at, there are 2 productions it has. Alternative productions. 2 productions it has. You need to look at the first symbol of the S. If you look at the first symbol of the production S, it says small I. It is terminal. Similarly, you need to look at the second production first symbol. It says small a. Both are terminal. The moment it is terminal, you are lucky. You need to write down I comma a. That's it. Next, S dash. What is the first of S dash? Epsilon, you write EP. EP is sufficient. E comma EP. Look at S dash. What is it? Has two different productions. This also has two different production. Look at the very first symbol. If you look at the very first symbol, it says small e. It is terminal. Look at the next production, alternative production. It says epsilon. Then first of S dash would become E comma epsilon. That's it. Now, what is the first of capital C? That's it. Excellent. It has only one production. That also has only one symbol. No other confusion. First of C is B. Look at these are all the first computation. A comma I comma A, how it had come, I am narrating. Then E comma epsilon, how it had come, I have narrated. Then B, B, that's it. So in this grammar, first computation is very simpler because all the symbol given in this grammar, very first symbol, luckily it is of the form terminals so that we are not facing any issues. So that easily we have computed. How we have computed? Illustration, look at first of S is right now it's not required. Okay, now compute the follow. Now you need to tell me what is the follow of S, capital S. Follow of capital S. Give your answer, then I will justify. E comma dollar. Okay, already has come. Look at S is available here. Look at here, it's at least here. S is available here. We need to mark all the availability of S first. Here one S is available. Here one S is available. So there are two S. If you look at S followed by S is S dash. Then if you look at this S followed by S is nothing. Now let us see. Very first, whenever we are finding follow of first symbol S, we need to blindly include dollar $i. This is a special symbol for a special purpose, loading the buffer or loading the stack. For that purpose, we are including dollar. Next, look at S followed by S dash. The moment S dash is given, we need to look at the first of S dash. What is available first of S dash? E comma epsilon. Substitute E here. Then if you substitute E, it would become E. Then substitute epsilon, it would become empty. The moment it becomes empty, we need to include follow of this S. Nothing is available now, only we are computing, so we cannot do anything. Then consider this S. Follow of this S is nothing, empty. So we need to include follow of S dash. Follow of S dash is also not yet computed, so we no need to worry for anything else. We are done. This is what follow of S dash. Now let us go for computing follow of S dash subsequently. Give your answer. Follow of S dash. Follow of S dash E comma dollar again. Yeah, let us see. Thank you, ma'am. We need to look at. Now let us look at, we need to first mark all the availability of S dash. We have only one instance. S dash, we have only one instance. Follow of S dash is nothing, empty. No one else is available. Now we need to include in this case follow of S. If the symbol followed nothing or empty, we need to include this left hand side follow. So now we are going to give follow. For this follow, what we are going to include is same, because follow of S is this, ditto we are going to copy paste. That's it. Now second is follow of C dash T. Let us see, we need to mark first. Let me mark, then you will come to know. We are looking for follow of C. First, let us mark this C. Capital C is available here. Let us mark. Let us look into who is sitting beside C, who is followed by C. There is this one symbol sitting beside. It is terminal. You are lucky. So if it is terminal, no more discussion. We need to include just the symbol which is followed by the follow to whom we are looking for. That's all. Now let us see to the table. Already I am done. Look at follow. Yes, we are right. Dollar E, E dollar T. In any order it could be. Again the same. The whatever here written in the form of grammar. Now our worry is to look into why this thing I have brought is we need to construct the table. When we construct the table, we need to refer first and follow, no? That's why I am bringing it. 1 minute, I'll align so that you can look into all together. This is not required, one is sufficient. Now let us look into all together. Let us design the table. Hope so it is visible for you guys. Look at. Always we need to constitute the table. See, one small mistake happened. Instead of this C, I'm going to replace it by capital E. That's all. This C is by capital E. Look at the grammar. Same grammar. Otherwise, we can design by ourselves. S, S dash. Instead of that C, capital E is available. Here E. Let us design our own way. Let me change this one. Yeah. Now, you tell me how many rows, how many columns. First, you need to tell me. I am displaying the grammar. You need to tell me how many rows and columns. First, tell me the rows and columns so that many number of table I can include. Rows and column, how many I need to do? How many rows, how many column? Row comma column. You just give me row comma column. Number. Three comma seven. Because three non-terminals, S, S dash, C. You are right. Three rows. How many terminals? I, T, E, B, A. Five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then $1. 6. Not 7. Yeah. 3 comma 6. That's all. C6 would have counted a little bit wrongly. Conceptually, if you are right, that is fine. 3 and 6 only our design of the table. Let me insert 3 rows. And I need to write the title also. So 4 rows. 4 rows. 6, 4, 5, 6 columns. Now I am going to here give yes, yes, yes dash, C. Here I need to give I. In any order I can write I, T, A. It doesn't matter. Order is not a matter. E, B, 5 has come, 6. I need to include one more. Insert, write. Finally, dollar. I need to include dollar. That's it. So these are all the design of table. Hope so you can understand. If you have got doubt, you can clarify with me. So this is the, please unmute your, how someone of you, kindly unmute yourself. Who is that? Yeah. We are not ready to do. Yeah. This is what? The table row and table column. Let us look at how to do S, I, how need to fill. For what we need to look at first. If we want to fill the table entries, to whom we need to look at? First step, what? Epsilon should not be included, ma. C6. Epsilon should not be included. Never table will have epsilon. This table itself we are designing or follow itself we are computing because of epsilon. Because computer cannot understand empty. No, Pavan. Not following, checking for follow. Recap. What I said. Table entry means what we supposed to look at. C6, is it clear, ma? Epsilon eradication, only this much work we are doing. So epsilon, no column should come. Never we consider epsilon. We consider it as terminal during our first and follow computation. By the time we say that it is terminal. But while we are constructing a table, epsilon is not at all allowed because computer cannot recognize emptiness. See, I'm telling, I'm going to give you chocolate. You will be asking, give me, or else you will open my hand and see. It is empty. Nothing is available. You can recognize emptiness. Machine cannot recognize emptiness. That is non-trivial solution they used to call. C6, is it clear, ma? Why epsilon should not be included? Yes, fine. Now, Pavan, it is not checking the follow. What is the exact thing? Tell me. Until any one of you give right answer, I will not proceed. To whom we need to look at while filling the entry? Yeah, exactly. G2, right. First, we need to look at. If epsilon comes in the first only, we are going for follow. I need to write in different way. 1 minute. Give me a second. I'll include one table. So that first and follow, I'll copy. Insert. To entry. First, let me copy here. This is first. Then let me copy the follow. Then we proceed. I think this also not sufficient. This grammar also we would be required. We would be in the need. We need to look at grammar as well as all together. What is the thing happening? Yeah. Now let us look at one by one. S of I. Sorry. Yeah, first S. We need to look at first of S. It has I. It has A. Then we need to think in our brain, focusing on the column I. We need to focus this column I. And we need to focus this column. It is too dark. So let me erase this one. So our focus is on these two columns. S pair. S and I. I said na capital A, small a. Entry. Always it will be in the form of a pair between non-terminal and terminal. S and I. If I look at S and I, what is the production starting with I? That only I need to fill the entry, not A. I need to fill the entry. Now, what is the next production for A? S producers. I need to fill the entry, small a. Now we are done. Table filling for the symbol S, we are done. No more work for the row 1. Row 1, we are done very absolutely. Now, row 2, we need to proceed. When we want to proceed with row 2, S dash. We need to look at the first of S dash. When I look into first of S dash, E. Yes, absolutely, it is terminal. No worries. I need to focus. I need to keep on my eye towards the table entry E. Yes, I am done. Then what is the production I need to give? S dash produces E. Yes. I am done. Absolutely. Next, look at the symbol epsilon. There is no column called epsilon column. That is why we need to look at this entry. We need to look at this entry. Follow of S dash. We need to look at follow of S dash. It says E as well as it says dollar. Now what symbol, what production need to include? Epsilon production, because we are going for follow because of this epsilon. Now how I need to include, let us look at. See, follow of S dash is E. Then follow of S dash is E means because of this epsilon only I have come here. Now the problem comes, that problem let us discuss later. Just because of this availability of E symbol in the follow, I'm including this epsilon. That is fine. Next, dollar. Dollar has come because of this epsilon. So that I need to include the production S dash epsilon to the dollar entry. Yes, I have included. Now let us look into first of C. First of C is B. There is only one production. No confusion. B is the column we need to focus. I need to copy paste this production. Now our things are over. Now where is the problem? This question itself, check whether the grammar is LL1 or not. Now tell me whether this grammar is LL1 or not. Second problem only I am teaching, not first problem. That all over. Any one of you tell me. This problem is LL1 or not? How you need to justify the answer also? No, very good. D7. It is not LL1. Then why? Why it is not LL1? It should have one production. Excellent. Multiple entry. Again, non-determinism. It leads to non-determinism because of this table entry. This table has double entry. this double entry one place, if it exists also, that grammar is not a LL1 grammar. We did a recap also. Through the recap, we learned new concept, that is called, it is not a LL1. That's it. Is it clear, guys? So this is the grammar we started with. Now the question is, check whether the grammar is, verify whether the given CFG is LL1 or not. The question for this grammar is this. Now your answer is, it is not LL1 grammar. Why? Because the entry M of S dash comma E has multiple entries. Why? Because M of S dash comma E has multiple entries. This is the ultimate answer. We need to kind enough to design the table all the time. After designing the table only, we will come to know. Initially, you and me cannot take decision. We should be good enough designing the parsing table from the beginning, that using 7 steps. See, what I recapped, could you able to understand now? Free from ambiguity, free from left recursion, free from left factoring, first computation, follow computation, parse table construction. We need to do with, these all we didn't go. We didn't even touch upon this. Within that, we are trying to do whether it is multiple entry. If it is not, if it is LL1 only, we can do this. If this is true, we proceed with step 8. If it is true, go to step 8. Otherwise, stop. Guys, could you able to understand what I'm trying to tell? Up to step number 6, all are same. If the moment we see multiple entry, we need to stop our process. Not even one. You complete the table construction. At the end, you need to conclude. Now we cannot do what is called parsing action. That is why we are moving to the third unit, bottom-up parser. There are some limitations with this. This is the limitation. Although it is free from ambiguity, left recursion, left factoring, it is free from all kind of non-determinism. What would be the problem we will be facing is multiple entry problem. Again, non-determinism. That is the power or capability of this grammar. We need to move on to the third unit or bottom-up parser. This is the answer for why I need to learn. Not because of it is given in the syllabus. Because of this limitation, multiple entry limitation, we need to move to bottom up parser. Then another trick is what? Another part of discussion we need to do with unit 2 is error recovery mechanisms. Although there are errors, see, this is not error. This is during the design itself we are coming to know. But there are few error, auto recovery is possible. Although user tend to commit mistakes, the parser itself will have the innate capability to skip certain errors or to able to handle certain errors. Some we used to call now warnings. Sometimes warnings will come. Although it is warning, it will able to capable of handling that. That is the kind of position. How to, what are all the things happening, how it is happening. A kind of a short discussion, some 5 to 10 minutes of discussion. With that, we can move on to the unit number 3. But I wanted to conduct MCQ. Now, this concept I didn't cover. That is why I'm holding. Wednesday, you need to undergo MCQ. Everything is officially recorded. Because principals are asking us to conduct one assignment, one test, and one MCQ. 3 things we supposed to do for each and every unit. So, I'll be starting for this unit on Wednesday. Multiple choice question. First 10 minutes you can have interaction QA session. Then we move for this discussion. That's all about the second type of grammar. If you have any doubt, the same grammar only, instead of capital C, it is there with E. It doesn't require, otherwise you will get confusion. Now this is third grammar. Look at, I'll just pause a while. You need to understand. You need to come out with, if you have doubts, you need to come out. Now holistic picture. See, this is the grammar. This grammar is LL1 because see, all the entries are single entry. Now you need to understand. I'm just displaying. You need to understand. If you have got doubt, you can ping me. I can explain. That's it. With that, today we are concluding. Look at this grammar. First go for first computation, next follow computation, next design the table. That's it.